Hello and welcome to the video. Today we are doing the OG Purge Mask, female edition. Okay, I will show a picture here of what I mean. Yeah, so today I wanted to do the makeup for the Purge. I've seen lots of the little cross ones online, the ones that are LED. Seen lots of people recreate those, and they'll look bomb, like they'll look great. But I figured though you can go out and buy those masks like for £10 and they're really nice, they're really good, they're LED, they're light up, they're cool. So maybe people wouldn't be as interested as seeing that. But the other masks are, while scary, it's not really something you want to wear, I don't think. Anyway, I just figured you can buy these masks as well, but they're just not as cool as the other ones. So we're going to make it a bit more cool. And a bit.
Siobhan, are you using your shaving cream? The night, when you come in there?
No. I had a shave when I came in. I want to go for a bath right enough, but I've not done it yet.
Okay,
I'll
just
going to moisturise my face. Then I'm going to use the Bobbi Brown face base. What? I use the top of my moisturiser as like a palette for my foundation, so that's exactly what I'm going to do, use any foundation. This is not the foundation I used that I had on a minute ago and I would have used that, but I'm just going to use this because I don't mind using it. So it's the L'Oreal Infallible 24 Hour Matte Foundation. This is too pale for me, but it's going to get covered with other bits for the Purge Mask anyway, so I don't mind. Jesus. Yeah. See, when I said I don't mind using it, this is why. Because there's no other opportunity to use this foundation because it's just too pale for me. Like, oh god. Oh well.
Right.
What I'm gonna do now is the brows. Brows. The Maybelline Tattoo Brow. Old Reliable. I'm just gonna go under. Realistic for the Purge Mask, you could block out your brows and do skinny ones like the mask, but again I want to make this a bit more wearable and I don't want my brows to be skinny. It's just not for me. I'm just going to go over that, comb through, then I have my Huda Beauty eyebrow pencil and I'm just going in at the front and drawing some lines in there. Because my front bits are a bit bald as well. Nice. This would look better if my skin tone was matching my actual complexion. Like, that's ridiculous. I'm not. just going to go in with, that's kind of dark, so I'm going to go in with this dark brown. It is called I'm Close. And I'm just going to go all over the eye. And round the circle. It doesn't really matter how messy you are with this, obviously the lines are a guide, but you can clean up anything because I've not done anything over here, so you can clean it all up and then sort it. Okay, so again, still have a palette full of that very light foundation, and we're just going to clean this up a bit. So up here is a bit kind of smoky as well, but I'm not too worried about that. I'm just going back in over anything that I feel is not quite sitting right with a small brush. Yeah, that's fine. Sister's not doing. Now, on this mask, around the eyes, there is some pink blushy tones, which is exactly what I'm going to do so we don't look like a raccoon. Maybe like a burglar, actually. Or like a Pretty Reckless fangirl. Nothing wrong with the three of those things, but it's not the look we're going for. So I'm just going to take, this is the number 7 blush in Berry Crush, and I'm just going to go around. There's also blush on the forehead. I'm just going to do that right up, why not? With a small brush and some eyeshadows. Just like a light brown eyeshadow, I'm going to carve out where my teeth will be. I'm just going to take some Snazzy face paint, good old reliable, honestly, have used them every year since I bought them. I went over the brown a bit because I didn't think it was looking very smiley, and that's obviously what I want. I have a Soap and Glory red lipstick, And all I'm going to do is go into that, and we're just going to do the lipstick. I think I just need to create some kind of illusion here, or even shadowing, just so the cheeks are a bit more intimidating. Maybe a bit of mascara. You know what I'm going to do? Like very lightly with maybe the shade Knee Pads, which is kind of like a lighter brown. And maybe go in and do some teeth. There we are. Just went round with some eyeshadow, drew some teeth, then went back over and actually with a white. I'm just gonna try and blend that out a bit. I think that's it. I think this is the finished look. It's like the Purge mask, but makeup, I'd say. Spooky enough. Scoot back then. There we go, guys. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!
Sorry, I don't know that one.
Okay.